Good day, one and all. Thank you for joining us here at WSKI TV 17 or at our website, WSKITV.com, where you can see this forecast for the Maine High Peaks region all year round, as well as tons of other information. Brought to you by Village to Go, located in Village West. And for Monday, we expect to pick up a few more inches of snow, which is A-OK. 15 to 19 up top, 22 to 26 at the base, a little bit of a breeze, not enough to interfere with any of the lift operations, hopefully. That snow will last overnight, so do be aware if you're out and about on the roads. Then the rest of the week is looking pretty fine. We'll start out with partly sunny skies on Tuesday, 11 to 15 up top, 25 to 29 at the base. Nice temperatures, not really too cold at all. And we do like the end of February. That's when the sun starts to get higher in the sky and more noticeable. Partly sunny on Wednesday and Thursday, and full sunshine on Friday at this point. 31 for a high on Wednesday, so that's downright warm. 23 at the summit Thursday, 26 at the base, 14 up top, and then Friday, 11 at the bottom, and 4 degrees at the summit. Birchwood Interiors brings you our trail conditions for Monday. We're looking at 155 trails and trail sections, loose granular, packed powder. Groomers have been absolutely killing it up there, and we are back to our midweek schedule of lift operation. We expect to groom Timberline, Bridle Chain, Tote, Spurline, Kings, Hayburner, Half a Skidder, Gauge, Comp Hill, Spillway, Sluice, Go-Go Line, White Nitro, Wedge, Haywire, Candyside, Lower Winter's Way, Boardwalk, Landing, Birches, and Snowbrook down here in the flats. And on the east side, Hallback, Widowmaker, Flume, Ram Down, Lower Boomauger, Two Hall, Whiffle Tree, Slasher, Rollway, and Moose Alley. If you have little ones, be sure to take a special trip over there to see that. On West Mountain, they'll do Scoot, Windrow, Good Chance, and Horseshoe Trails. And every single night, the Terrain Park crew works on all the terrain parks. From beginner to expert, there's something for everybody, so be sure to stop by and check them out when you're up on the hill. Here's the lift schedule for Monday morning. 8:30 start for Snubber, Skidway, and Sawduster at the base of the mountain, serving the beginner terrain there. 8:30 also startup time for the Super Quad, Skyline, Double Runner East in the center part of the mountain. 9 o'clock start over on the east side for King Pine and Whiffle Tree. Whiffle Tree is a great family-friendly area on the lower east side. Up top is our summit chairlift. 9 o'clock start for Timberline. Should be good to go. A little bit of a breeze. So dress for winter. If you want to do some cross-country skiing, conditions are wonderful at the Outdoor Center. They're also great for snowshoeing. And the ice rink is open every single day, including evenings on Saturday, Tuesday, and Thursday. Always something to add another day to your reason to stay at the Sugarloaf Outdoor Center. And fat bike trail conditions are starting to come around after that squirrely snow. It's packed in a little bit more. March it tread as temperatures rise in the middle of the week, but hopefully things will just continue to get better. And Arnold Trail Snowmobile Club reports excellent sledding from the Canadian border to Kingfield. They now have donation boxes at different intersections. Hey, there's a note for Carabasset Valley and their mountain bike trails. Drop a few bucks in, if you would please, for the groomers. There's a blood drive coming up at the hotel this coming Thursday. Please sign up if you can help. The need is there, as always. And if you want to know before you go, you won't find another source of information like WSKI TV 17 delivers, not just on Channel 17, but Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, in addition to our website. Check out our quad cam, streaming all year round.